It is Numbers 20 verse 11. Okay, Numbers 20 verse 11, the Bible says, and Moses lifted up his hand, and with his rod, he smote the rock twice, and the water came out abundantly, and the congregation drank, and their beast also. You know, the rod with the power. The rod of Moses had power. He, in the desert, he smites his rod against a rock and water flows. That's how the power of that rod was. The rod that Moses has holding in his hand, he strike the desert and he smite the desert and the water started flowing. That was the power. How can the water from the rock, just the rock, when Moses strike the rod, in the rock and the water started flowing from there. That was so powerful. We thank God that God who has the rod is so powerful that he can bring the water from the rock. Now, when we talk about the rock of the devil, the Bible says in Psalms 125 verse 3, for the rod of the wicked shall not rest upon the rod of the righteous. Lest the righteous put forth their hands unto iniquities. Now, here, there is a rod of the wicked that prevail, that destroy human being. There is the rod of witchcraft. You see, when the devil was looking and see and saw how Moses was using the rod, he went and made his own rod of the wicked to destroy the rival people, to destroy innocent people. The rod of the wicked symbolizes the authority of the enemy in your life. So now the enemy has authority over your life because he has went and duplicated the rod. The rod that we are talking about, the enemy operates with it to punish people. It comes at a different stage of a person's life. For some people, this rod manifests in their life right from the womb. When some people have quarrel with their parents, the Lord will break the staff of the wicked upon your life in the name of Jesus. The Lord will break the staff of the wicked upon your life in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the rods of the wicked come in various shapes, colors, and size. When the enemies desire to terminate the good things in our life, they may plant their rod in such a life or in his or her home. Sometimes they carry the wicked rod on their head and stay with the person. There was a certain man who dealt in cars. He traveled to bring new cars to his place. But anytime he went for the new vehicles, the ones that were supposed to be his prophet. Could have accident. He did everything to stop the misfortune, but it did not stop. He began to lose his profit, and his capital was affected. The number of vehicles he brought reduced to 15 from 24, or from 100 to 0. Many of you have business. One time you have been having a lot of money, or you had a big business. Now you lose everything. You end up losing, closing down because the lord of the wicked has been planted in your business. Some of you see, you have your house, your mortgage. You've been paying. Then suddenly you lose that house with small amount that you cannot able to pay. When you miss 1 month, the second month, it is a disaster. All the money you paid, it is wasted like that. Sometimes you get a good job. You are thank God that you have a job. Tomorrow they would say, we don't need you, thank you, we don't need your service. When the rod of the enemy has blessed on your place, has blessed on your head, it will stay there and take everything from you. That's why we need to pray against the rod of the wicked. You see, the rod of Moses was so powerful, was delivering the children of Israel from their trouble, from the problem. But now when the devil saw it, he went and make his own rod. That's why Psalms was saying that the rod of the wicked will not prosper in your life in Jesus' name. When the situation become very bad, he decided to go to the mountain to pray. His only prayer was, "Oh Lord, give every enemy of my life a knock." I pray like this, and I mute your phone and pray like this. "Oh Lord, give every enemy of my life a knock in the name of Jesus." You need God to give your enemy a knock. You need God to give your enemy a knock to knock him down. K-N-O-C-K, a knock. You pray that this prayer. I want everyone, even you are in Periscope right there. "Oh Lord, give every enemy of my life a knock in the name of Jesus." You need God to give your enemy a knock, to knock him down. God will knock that person down. No, God will knock your enemies down in the name of Jesus. "Oh Lord, give every enemy of my life a knock in the name of Jesus." If you pray this prayer very well, you might see some people, their face is swollen, and then you will wonder what happened. God is going to give some your enemies knock until they will die if they are not going to repent and remove their rods from you. This man prayed with all his might and came back home. On getting back home, there set food for him to eat, and he was asking for his mother. The mother came, and as they were eating, the mother said, "Do you know that one of your children came to give me a knock?" Then the man said, "Excuse me, ma'am. I went out since morning. Please allow me to eat my food." As the man was eating, his mother received the second and the third knock. After she received the third knock, she could no longer sit. The man carried her to the bedroom and he asked her what happened, and she said back what happened. The man began prayer, a warrior, starting praying again as he said, "In the name of Jesus." God asked him, "Why asked you to pray now?" He said, "My mother is sick." God said, "Were you not the one who said I should knock her knock?" Then the man understood and said, "We would use the price of one car to do a burial." Because the mother died in the process, Thaddeus was out. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yapa shaka rabashutoro rabakuriaba. Rapapapashitoro rabakuria.
All callers are muted and they can unmute themselves.
Yes. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Repapapashitoro robokuriamba baba shanto. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father. Yes, Lord, we give you all the glory. A minister of God got married and was expecting that a baby would come in the first year. He and his wife prayed and fasted, but up to the sixth year, no baby came. They did not understand what was going on. They continued to pray. In the eighth year of their marriage, they had a baby. The baby started growing one day. They decided to visit the people in the village. As they got to the village, their parents were so happy and thanked God that they had the baby. The baby started running about. As he was doing so, his grandparents said to his parents, "Come, you don't know this village. Do not allow your son to run about too much." But the minister and his wife laughed and said, "Don't bother about that. We prayed for him. No evil could befall him." As the boy was running about, and the old man came to the minister and said, "Come, I want to see you." They told him that the man was the head of the wicked people in the village, that he should not go near him. As he entered the old man's house, the man said, "My son, welcome. I have something to show you." And the man removed his cap, and on his head was nailed all over. The minister wondered how the man could get nails all over his head. Then the old man now said to the minister, I will tell you the story. When you were getting married, we were three in number and said that nothing good would come from the marriage. And we started to fight you. Anytime your wife got pregnant, we removed it. But something started to happen. When we could all sit in our homes and a man could come with a nail and hammer and put the nail on our heads. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Father. Yes, Lord, my Father, we bless your name. Jesus, we love you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Muted.
So now you see, this man, the old man, when the minister got married, there was some wicked rod. They planned that they would marry, but they would not have children. They were wicked. Now this man went to pray and fasting and prayed the prayer that we prayed. Now these people were near the hand of God, near their heads. They break their heads because they knew what the prayer they were praying. There are some wicked rods that are prepared for people. Wicked people, witchcraft, they always prepare a rod to people. Now, if these people, they didn't know how to pray, they could die without having kids. That's men of you, men of us. Men of us, when you are getting married, people are happy celebrating, but the wicked, they say, okay, you are getting married, you will not have children. Okay, you are getting a job, you will not enjoy that job. That's why we have to pray very serious, a very aggressive prayer. Wicked rods are very dangerous, and many people, they have no idea how it works. Here, you got your children, you have beautiful children, they go to university, they get jobs, but no one is your child. Everyone is gone. They are scattered. All of them, they are mad, they are sick, they are depressed. They are home wandering. No one has been married. So those are the wicked, rod of the wicked. Yes. What areas do these wicked rods attack mostly? What areas? We want to look at the areas that this wicked rod attacks mostly. They attack the whole life of a person, the one called destiny. When they lay their rod on a wickedness upon the destiny of a person, the person will find it difficult to excel, example, simple things. You cannot control simple things. They attack marriages. They attack the vision of a person. They lay the rod of the business of some people. When this happened, the people would just be there. They would not have anything to show that they are doing business. They attack parts of a person's body. For example, the womb, the protective organ, the hand, the legs, and the heart. They attack the protecting of the man. They will make a man cannot bring another woman. That is the rod of the wicked. A man cannot bring another woman. They attack the womb of a woman. That's why you need very aggressive prayer. When you don't know this prayer, you will end up childless. You will end up having a husband, and that's why many people, they divorce because of that. That's the rod attacked soul. What to do to usually achieve? What to do that wants to promote when they lay this rod of wickedness on a person? They want to promote scarcity of blessing. If there is a regular flow of good things into that life, they will terminate it. So they use this rod to direct a person and to contrary path, and the person will think he is still on the right path. You find a person going in a wrong direction. Like now, I want to warn you some things that some people, what they are involved. There is the merchandise called souls of men. These people, they will come and start selling to you some stuff, and they lie on you that when you sell is when you get more money. Of course, yes. But behind it, they are selling your souls. you go to that business, at the end of the day, you lose and you pay so much. By the time you build that business, you have finished all your money. Then you end up losing the business you had. They are very smart. Therefore, they will lay a rod that will steal your money. Even this is what we call an addiction of charity, of Rotary. It's called Rotary. You go there, you buy, you are expecting you win. You will never win. Your money, it will go like that. So that is a rod. They will replace a rod on you, which takes you to do things that you are not supposed to do. They promote frustration. A young man came to us about he had a good job. So this man, since he had a good job, he was very happy that he has a good job. He was very happy, you know, when you have a good job, you are happy about the job. But he didn't know that the rod has been placed on him. And then something happened. He was working in the bank. After that, after 1 week, the money, huge money, got lost. The rod was blessed on him. And then I call wherever who did that, God knows. Now the money was lost. The money disappeared, a big amount of money. Then when the money is lost like that, it involved police, SAD, and the money was picked. He was locked in. And now the rod was blessed, and that was the end of his job. By the time they found to clear him, the job is gone, and they can't get a job anymore. The rod was blessed to him. So we pray that God will protect you from the rod of the wicked. That's why we need to stop this. A prayer to destroy the authority of the enemy in your life in Jesus' name. Yes, thank you, Jesus. There are so many, many, many ways that we will stop this. When do this enemy lay their lords? When you start in signing, the moment you start signing, they will come and attack you so hard. The moment you start business, the moment you start enjoying yourself, they will come and put a rod on you. When you are doing better things, they will come and put a rod on you. They will start fighting you. Example of my sister. My sister, the lady, she's one of our students, by the way. Judith, the one who was giving a testimony yesterday. Judith was giving a testimony yesterday. And she just graduated from her PhD. And she's doing well. Now she was attacked from everywhere. A job, children, everywhere she was attacked. Because the enemy, they have seen that Judith is going to grow, become a manager, to take over. So they started attacking her so hard. And she's a Christian. She's a minister. She's one of our students. Then now you see the rod was blessed on her. If she did not join us, if we didn't know this, the prayer, she could have lost her son, and herself also, she could be dead because she was attacked by the arrow was sent to her heart. The arrow was sent directly to her heart to kill her. And after that, her son could have followed her. That's how the enemy wanted to wipe her, completely silence her. That's when we need to pray. We need to pray. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. We thank God that God is able to destroy the rod of the wicked. We will pray that God will destroy them in the name of Jesus Christ. What must we do? What must we do? We should see that you are just better. You cannot explain the cause of this bitterness. You have to repent and ask God to remove every satanic rod in your life in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I know the Holy Spirit is reminding me something. We have a big testimony today. Before we go to pray, I want everyone to hear that the testimony that we have. Yesterday we prayed. That's why I'm telling you the prayer. This prayer, it is the deliverance prayer to help people. Yesterday there's one of our member. It's my son. He had a case in court, and this case has been worried him so much. I told him don't worry. I prayed and I saw a suit man kissing him, hugging him. So I told him, I've seen this case is gone. Don't worry about it. And when he went to the court this morning, The court was dismissed, he was set free. Are you there, Dave? Dave, are you on the prayer line or you are on Periscope? Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. We thank God that God is able to throw away your case. If as we pray this prayer, it works. A lady, one time, there was a lady who gave a testimony that her husband has left her with the children and they went and lived with another woman. Now this woman, I told the woman that don't cry, stop. Yeah, Dave, can you come on prayer line? Yes. Now, this woman, she was crying. I told her, no, don't cry, stop now. Stop, you have cried enough. I will stop that. I'm going to set a prayer to stop that strange woman who has taken your husband. You don't have to give your husband away. If you are in this prayer and your husband is running away, call me. I'm telling you that you will see the husband is coming back. Because if some of you knew this prayer, your husband cannot leave you. Or your wife cannot leave you. This prayer, it is called deliverance prayer. It delivers people. It helps you. It is restoration. It can restore back what you have lost. Even your business, your jobs, it is going to restore back. Dev, are you on the prayer right now? Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Okay, he's in Periscope. So we'll give him time tomorrow to give a testimony. He's very happy the case was thrown away. So he win the case. Therefore, everyone that is having the rod of the case in court, it is going to be destroyed. We've been praying for one of the son. Our dear sister Rinda, her son is in prison, Bida. So we have been praying for him. Soon he's coming out. Another young man called Harvest Davidson. Also, we are praying for him.
Callers are muted.
Yes. So he's going to come out.
Unmuted.
Hallelujah. Dev, are you on the line now?
Okay.
Yes, can you give the testimony?
Yes, ma'am, I've been trying to come out, but the phone has been mute on your end.
Okay, Treasures will take care of that.
Yes.
Yes, go ahead.
Yes, ma'am, so we thank everyone. Our name is David. Yes. Yes, I'm Pastor Christian. I prayed for me last night on Periscope about my court case that I had this morning. I should prophesy to me and told me that the case is thrown away. And when I went there, it was all thrown away, it was all done. I was so amazed and amused, you know. Amused, oh God, you're so good. And delivered me from the hands of the enemies, you know. But it has really helped me a lot for the past 3 years. I had high blood pressure. And I was delivered from high blood pressure too, you know. Yes. But God is good. Just give God the glory, you know? And I thank you so much, Pastor Christine.
Amen. 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 Thank you, Dave. Thank you so much. God bless you. We were so happy about that because it was giving him a lot of stress, and I told him,
amen, thank you.
Don't worry about that. God bless you. So as we are going to ask God to give a knock to the enemy tonight is going to be knocked in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Treasure, can you unmute these people everywhere now? And you can unmute them back when we want to pray. Yes. I pray that God will knock out your enemy. The enemy that is attacking you all this time is going to be knocked down in Jesus' name. We thank God that God is able. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. William, thank you for coming, my son. My son William, I pray that God will knock down the enemy that is attacking you. God is going to give a knock, a good one, to knock them down in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, as we are going to pray, I pray that God repent every sin. Ask God to forgive you. Every sin, you have to pray, God, tell God, God, my Father, I am a sinner before your eyes. Forgive me, God, in the name of Jesus. Now, when you are going to pray this prayer, This prayer is going to work for your enemy. You pray like this: Oh Lord, give the enemy of my progress the knock of death in Jesus' name. And I meet with the people, I want to hear them. Or you can write on there. Yes, my sister. Yeah, Rinda. Rindy, Dr. Juma, please write this. Oh Lord, give the enemy of my progress the knock of death in Jesus' name. Let God give the enemy of your progress a knock of death. This God needs to give them a knock of death because they are holding your progress. Rinda called me, Dr. Rinda Mazinga, our student. She called me that she has lost a file document, very important document. So she was stressed. The Holy Spirit told me, I just hold a picture and I was praying for her. I said, something is not right. Something is not right. I started praying for her. Now she called me, she was stressed. She lost the very important document. Very, very important document that could have made it worse. Then I told her, you will find it, go home and call me. And that is exactly, she reached home and called me, oh God, I got the document. Yeah, she was running, she was like, she was going to crazy, because that document was very important to her life. It was the car, everything was there in that file. Well, the file, the enemy took it and hide it, she could not find it. She looked it, she went up and down, she could not find the file. Until the prayer has to reveal where the file is. You see, the rod was pressed on that file to, the file to disappear, then the time to expire, and the interest will go up, and even she will lose everything. So we are going to ask the Lord to knock that enemy to death in Jesus' name. You pray that prayer, if you can write, she has write it down so you can copy it from the Periscope you prayed. I will send it to you. If you get me your email, you send me WhatsApp, or I can get these prayers because I want everybody to pray these prayers. Oh Lord, give the enemy of my progress the knock of death in the name of Jesus. The enemy needs a knock of death. The enemy needs a knock of death completely from your life in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, visit my enemies in a wonderful way that they will never forget your anger in the name of Jesus. That's how you pray. You pray that, oh Lord, visit my enemies in a wonderful way that they will never forget your anger in the name of Jesus. If God can visit your enemies with wonderful way, with anger, they will never forget and come to you. I was praying during the prayer, evening prayer. I saw the witchcraft. I saw evil people. They are very angry with me. I saw God refused to open my eyes. I saw in their camp how they wanted to come and attack you. I said, I bleed the blood of Caesar. I send fire right now. I ask the angels of God to help me and send fire to their camp and burn them. Yes, I Lord, visit my enemy in a wonderful way that they will never forget your anger in Jesus' name. That's the prayer you pray. Every wicked rod in my family, receive the fire of God and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. Every wicked rod in my family, receive the fire of God and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Receive the fire of God and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. I pray every wicked rod in your family, I command them to receive fire. I call the fire of God to burn them to ashes. The fire of God can deal with those wicked rods in your family. Household wicked. They are household wicked that they have pressed a lot on you. I pray for even my children, my family, my life and your family and your children. I pray every household wickedness rod, let them receive fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. You wicked authority drag into your life, behind, be paralyzed by fire in Jesus' name. Every wicked, yes, thank you, sister. You wicked authority dragging your life behind, be paralyzed by fire in the name of Jesus. I want you to hold your head. After you are holding your head, you pray like this. My head reject the influence of the rod of the wicked in Jesus' name. You hold your head like this. You pray that my head reject the influence of the rod of the wicked in the name of Jesus. I pray that you will reject, that your head reject every influence of the rod of the wicked in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, blood of Jesus, deliver my head from the authority of the wicked in Jesus' name. You pray, blood of Jesus, deliver my head from the authority of the wicked in Jesus' name. This prayer is going to deliver you many. You will be surprised how this is a deliverance prayer. It is going to deliver you, many of you, about so many people wherever, all over the world, who will do this prayer. That's why I'm praying slowly. Blood of Jesus, deliver my head from the authority of the wicked in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, deliver my head from the authority of the wicked in Jesus' name. Let the blood of Jesus deliver your head from the authority of the wicked. The wicked, they are wicked. They are so wicked and wickedly. The Bible itself says God hates them every day in the name of Jesus. The rod of the wicked, I terminate your affairs in my marriage, in my finances, in my life, in my family, in the name of Jesus Christ. You terminated them. You commanded them to cut off from your life in Jesus' name. You wicked rod, opposing my open heaven, roasted in Jesus' name. The enemy can prepare a rod to lock your heavens. So wherever you pray, your prayer does not go anywhere. The prayer just hang here and come back. So the enemy will bless a rod. Remember, the enemy blessed a rod of Daniel. Daniel prayed 21 days. The first day Daniel was praying, his prayers was heard. God answered him. But the rod of the enemy was holding the prayers, that the prayers could not come. That's how powerful or wicked the enemy is. He's still there. He holds people's prayer. You've been praying so much. You pray a lot of prayer. But the enemy takes them. So today, tonight, you command them to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. You wicked rod that is oppressing my heavens, roast in fire in the name of Jesus. You pray this prayer that God is going to pray. I pray that God will release your protective system from the authority of the wicked by fire in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, you will get this prayer. I will give it to you. These prayers, they are there, and you will get it free. Once you send me, you want it, you request them. I'm not going to send everybody. I want those people who could pray these prayers. Oh Lord, accelerate your glory in my life by fire in Jesus' name. I pray that God will accelerate the glory in your life by fire in the name of Jesus. Holy Lord of hosts, mighty army in battle, glory to your name, holy name in Jesus' name. I pray that God of hosts, God who is in battle God of war, let him, God that does not change, start fighting the enemy that is using the wicked rod against your life in Jesus' name. That's why we pray, Lord of hosts, mighty army in battle, glory to your holy name in the name of Jesus. God is a holy God. It's our Father is a holy God. So he will fight for the enemy that is using wicked rod to attack you in the name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, destroy every seed of destruction sowed against my glory in Jesus' name. You pray that God will destroy every seed of destruction sowed against your glory. You know your glory can be attacked. When you see people cutting your hair, when you see people are tampering with your hair, attacking your hair, touching your hair, that is they're tampering with your glory. And when your glory is attacked, you are nothing. That's why you need to destroy the city of destruction in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that tonight, many people that the rod of the wicked has been affecting them, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I see a woman scratching his head, saying, yes, that is true. The rod of the wicked attacking your marriage, attacking your children, attacking your work, So you have nothing because of the wicked, the rod of the wicked. I command that rod of the wicked to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I bind them and I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. God is going to restore you. Everything you have lost, God is going to restore you. Restoration is coming. Your business is going to come back. All the years that you have been wasted, the Lord is going to restore back and renew you back in the name of Jesus. The whole has gone. New has come in Jesus' name. I was telling a woman that I was praying for her. I told her, you have to start new in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God will deliver you from the hands of the rod of the wicked in Jesus' name. I know somebody's in the line, is prayer line or periscope. This person, she lost everything. She doesn't have anything. One time she was having a lot of money. She was driving. She had everything, but it happened that she lost everything. God is going to restore back what you have lost. I know God is going to restore because that is what he said in the book of Joel. He said, everything that you have lost, the Lord is going to restore them double. Look at Job. Job lost everything, even including his children. But God blessed him double and more than what he has. Although he went through hellfire. So your time has come that God is going to restore you back. As long as you follow the prayers and you follow the rules, God will restore back everything you have lost. That sickness that has been in your life for a long time, God is going to heal you. I know some people that have been having some sickness, diseases that does not want to hear, does not want to go. Your time has come, it is going. That rod the enemy has placed on you, wicked rod, that the sickness, they don't want to respond with the prayers, with the medication. Doctors, you are still with that sickness. I prophesy against that sickness. It is going to be dried up and destroyed in Jesus' name. I am praying for a woman in your stomach, your belly. It has been bothering you so much. I am commanding those demons, python, snakes in that body to melt and be destroyed in Jesus' name. The backache, I am speaking to you right now. That rod that has been pressed on your back, I destroy them in Jesus' name. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I destroy every python and snakes in the hands and legs in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, rocket the rod of the wicked in all areas in the life of these people and destroy them by your fire in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost, rocket the rod of the wicked in all the areas in their life and destroy them by fire in Jesus' name. Rod of the wicked in your health, receive fire and burn to ashes, burn by fire in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus Christ, rod of the wicked in your finances, receive turned and burned to ashes in Jesus' name. There is rod of the wicked in your finances. That's why you can't have money. You are so broke. You can't have, your business is gone. You are so much in problem, in debt, because the rod of the wicked has been blessed on your money. I command thunder of God. Let them receive thunder. Let them receive fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The rod of the wicked in your ministry, crushed without recover. So the rod can bless on your ministry. You have a ministry, you have a call, but because the rod has been blessed there, so your ministry is dead. I command that rod to be crushed without recover in Jesus' name. That rod that has been pressed into your ministry, I command them to catch fire and crushed in Jesus' name. Sacred hands throwing you back to your emptiness. I command that hand to weather in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, arise, feed troubles. Let God feed your troubles with the fire day and night in Jesus' name. Let God torment them day and night. Let God torment them day and night. Let those demons be tormented day and night in Jesus' name. That's what they are. If they can praise a Lord of pain, you are suffering, a child of God. You serve a day, you don't sleep, and you don't know what to do. And the enemy is loving, is happy. Backfire. Let that pain to return back day and night and let them suffer. Not you to serve a child of God in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father. Angels of violence and horror, and violent, horrible angels, angels who does not have mercy, enter into the camp of the enemy and thrash them in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Holy Ghost, withdraw. I pray that the Holy Ghost withdraw your name and image from witchcraft coven. I pray that the Holy Ghost withdraw your name and your image from witchcraft coven. You know witchcraft, they will take your image, your picture, and your name to their coven. And then they start calling your name. You feel your body is very hot, getting, they call it hot flash. That is not a hot flash. It's satanic witchcraft coven. When they call your name, they cook you, you feel your body is burning. Because they call your name, they call and they chant your name, and they have taken your picture and put there, then you feel your body is being burned. Let me tell you that the enemy is a liar. Let the fire of God consume them and burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. I thank God. Jesus, Lord Jesus, break every vow of darkness made against you and rest up in Jesus' name. I pray that God will help you. God will deliver you in Jesus' name. Father of spirits, revise every demonic barrier that has been taken good things, good opportunity in your life in Jesus' name. I pray that God will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you very much. I have to stop here. God bless you. Have a wonderful night. Remember to call us if you have a need, if you have prayer request, we want to pray. You can call us. I will pray for you and stand with you. Go to our website www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. Go there and get your help from there. Also, this ministry is blessing you, go and donate. God loves you so much. I love you too. If you want to call us. Our number is 647-608-5207. You can reach me this number, 647-608-5207. Or you can go to our number 905-487-7196. You can reach me. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful night. We will be having 4 nights, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, 4 nights. Then Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we have morning, 8 o'clock a.m. 3 days, 4 nights, which means midnight. We have four midnight. We will do this until December. God will help us. Tomorrow we will start our prayer and fasting. If you want to join us prayer and fasting, you are welcome to do prayer and fasting. Tomorrow, that is Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Friday we open evening after 7 o'clock. And the prayer line, don't go when we finish the periscope. You stay on the line. If you want a prayer request, we will pray. I will pray for you. Don't go prayer line. Don't go. We need to pray. If you have any prayer, sister, unmute the people. Let the people come in and start praying. We will pray after we finish this prayer. Periscope, thank you so much. I appreciate you. I say bye-bye to you. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. I love you. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Tomorrow midnight, 12 midnight. Bye-bye, Periscope.